On a winter day, a man was standing in the middle of someone's front yard. The person stayed there for several weeks without moving, and the owner of the yard didn't mind. Eventually, the man left. Who was the man? It was a snowman, of course. He left a couple of weeks later when the temperature went up. Over winter break, five best friends each did different activities in different cities. Can you find out each friend's full name, what they did, and where they went? Their first names are Julie, Megan, David, Fred, and Sam. Their last names are Wallace, Thompson, Mallard, Shields, and Drake. Their preferred activities are a ski trip, moving to another place, a cruise, cooking classes, and visiting relatives. The places where they went are Houston, Paris, Cleveland, Vancouver, and Miami. And now, there's a bit more info you might need. 1. Julie and Miss Wallace were sad that David wasn't coming back. 2. Neither Sam nor Julie had ever left the U.S. before this winter break. 3. All the first names that have two syllables belong with the last names that have two syllables. Nobody's last name starts with the same letter as their first name. 4. Miss Mallard is excited to learn about French cuisine. 5. Mr. Thompson doesn't want to move. 6. The friends, in no particular order, are as follows. The girl who is going on a ski trip, Mr. Shields, Megan, the boy headed to Houston, and Julie. 7. Cruises can only be taken in warm coastal cities. Ski trips can only be taken in cold, mountainous places. Remember that this winter. 8. The cruise ship Fred is traveling on does not dock in Houston. Also, keep in mind that Sam can be a boy's or girl's name. In this case, it's short for Samantha. Julie Mallard takes cooking classes and she went to Paris. Megan Wallace moved to Cleveland. David Thompson visited his relatives in Houston. Fred Shields went on a cruise in Miami. Sam Drake took a ski trip in Vancouver. It's 1962, and you're traveling to Innsbruck, Austria, to see the Winter Olympics. When you arrive at the stadium, nobody is there. You ask a passerby, "Why isn't anyone here for the Winter Olympics?" The man answers your question. You both laugh at your silly mistake, and you go back home. What did the passerby tell you? He told you that the Winter Olympics wouldn't start until 1964. There are a few airplanes on the island. The tank of each airplane contains just enough fuel to fly halfway around the world. Any amount of fuel can be transferred from one plane to another while in the air. The only source of fuel is on the island. It's assumed that all the planes burn fuel at the same rate and fly at the same speed. What is the smallest number of airplanes needed to ensure that one plane flies all the way around the world? All the planes should return safely to the island. Only three planes are needed. Planes A, B, and C leave the island together. After flying 1/8 of the distance, plane C transfers 1/4 of the contents of its tank to plane A and 1/4 to plane B. This leaves C with 1/4 of its fuel, which is just enough to get back to the island. Planes A and B continue for another 1/8 of the way. Plane B then transfers 1/4 of the contents of its tank to plane A. Plane B now has half a tank of fuel left, which is enough to go back to the island. Plane A now has a full tank and continues to fly until it runs out of fuel, which occurs when it's 1/4 of the way to the island. It is met by plane C, which has already been refueled. Plane C transfers 1/4 of its tank to plane A, and they both head home. Planes A and C run out of fuel when 1/8 of the way to the island is left. Luckily, they're met by plane B, which has been refueled too. Plane B transfers 1/4 of its tank to each of the two planes, and the three aircraft now have enough fuel to get home. Two 50-foot ropes are suspended from a 40-foot ceiling 20 feet apart. You have only a knife. How much of the rope can you steal? Almost all of it. First, tie the ropes together at the ends. Then, climb one of the ropes. Make a loop as close to the ceiling as possible. While hanging from the loop, cut the rope just below it. But don't drop it, otherwise you'll be stuck up there. Run the rope through the loop and tie it to your waist. Swing over to the other rope and pull the rope that's going through the loop tight. Cut the other rope as close to the ceiling as possible, holding tight to the end of it. Once the rope is loose, you will swing down below the loop. Let yourself down to the ground by letting the rope out. At the bottom, untie yourself and pull the rope completely through the loop. At this point, you'll have all the rope except what was used to tie the loop. You find yourself trapped in a medieval castle far away from civilization. It's freezing outside. You can't jump out the window because it's too high above the ground. And even snowdrifts won't make the jump softer. The only tree growing near the window doesn't look sturdy enough for you to climb down. However, there are three doors, one of which can lead you to freedom. But behind the first door, there's a fierce fire. The second door holds back hundreds of venomous snakes. And behind the third door, there's a pitch dark maze, and you can only imagine what surprises are waiting for you there. Which door should you choose? The third one. You'll just need to break off a tree branch, turn it into a torch by lighting it in the first room, and go through the maze, which wouldn't be dark anymore. When Mary came to work after a winter break, she realized that the office had been robbed.
No.
The night guard said he had been patrolling the building when he'd heard suspicious noises. When he got there, he saw that the office door was wide open, and so was the safe. The man also added that he had looked out of the window and noticed someone get in a car. But the sun blinded him, and he didn't manage to see who it was. Mary instantly called the police. Why? There's no sun at night, so it couldn't have blinded the night guard. He must have invented the whole story to help the criminals. Or is he the thief himself? Tina and Timothy loved adventures. Once, they decided to check out an ancient castle in Greenland that was said to belong to a witch. That witch used snow to perform her magic and could turn into any object and copy anyone's appearance. In the castle, they used torches to light their way.
Oh, no.
All of a sudden, their torches went out. Tina got terribly scared. But then, the torches lit again, and she saw two husbands of hers in front of her. Can you tell who is her real husband? It's the man on the right. He has five fingers, like a regular human. The man on the left has four fingers, so it must be the witch. An anonymous person called the police and told them that a notorious criminal had come back to the town. The next day, they called the police once again to report the screams they had heard. They had been coming from an abandoned house. The police rushed there. They broke in and saw three tied-up men. They figured out that one of them must have been the criminal. One of the officers said that he knew exactly who the criminal was. Can you spot them? Look at the man on the left. Can you see a phone in his pocket? A true criminal would never let their victim use a phone. Take him, officer!
That's it for today. So hey, if you pacified your curiosity, then give the video a like and share it with your friends. Or if you want more, just click on these videos and stay on the bright side.